Alibaba also debuted in China, as we just talked about, but unlike the U.S. counterparts, Chinese shoppers aren't waiting in long lines. CCTV's Hu Xiangchen reports from Shanghai.
Black Friday's debut in China is good news for domestic shopping recommendation websites like 买个便宜货, which means buy something cheap in Chinese. The site was founded by Dong Jianwei 2 years ago when he was a university student. The young entrepreneur claims to have nearly 600,000 registered users and expects his revenue to jump 3 to 4 times this month, boosted by November's multiple shopping sprees.
We have seen enormous growth in new users since Singles Day, which drove a lot of web traffic to us. Now that Alipay supports RMB payments for many overseas merchants, it will bring significant benefits to small companies like ours.
Alipay played a crucial role in processing the massive transactions on the Chinese version of Black Friday, Singles Day, November 11th. Alipay handled $9.3 billion during that single 24-hour shopping frenzy. Ma Zheng is group marketing head of the international division at Ant Financial Services, the parent of Alipay.
Our business expansion is following users' demands. We see a growing number of consumers who want to buy things from overseas. Alipay works at the bridge to connect Chinese consumers with foreign merchants and brands.
Alipay is now one of the payment options for over 2,000 consumer merchants and brands globally. This year, it has caught some big fish in the United States, including big-name American retailers like Macy's, Bloomingdale's, Saks Fifth Avenue, and Neiman Marcus. Alipay has also launched a new service called ePass. Aaron Ni works at a foreign bank in Shanghai and is one of China's estimated 18 million international internet shoppers. She thinks the ePass service will help solve logistic issues, which has always been her biggest concern.
I've been shopping on the Black Friday sales for many years, mainly through Amazon. Some other overseas websites don't have international delivery, so I would use third-party transit services for them. It would take 3 or 4 weeks for the package to arrive, and the random inspections by the customs in Shanghai could further delay it. But with the one-stop delivery service provided by Alipay, I can expect my package to arrive in about 2 weeks.
According to PayPal, China will have 130 million users of overseas procurement services by 2018, when they are forecast to spend more than $300 billion. Alibaba's international e-commerce services are not only helping out these consumers, but also small businessmen like Dong Jianwei, whose company took in 500,000 RMB last month alone. Wang Linghuan, ICS for CCTV, Shanghai.